Here, we are introduced to a strong woman, a single mother named Anne. Anne is an independent figure, with a stable financial life and a steady job. She also has a beautiful little daughter named Emma, who is the source of her happiness. However, one day Anne receives a visit from a guest who is no stranger to her. The guest is Owen, the adopted son she has cared for since he was 9 years old. Although her smile remains, there is something hidden behind Anne's expression when she sees Owen. This visit is different because Owen is not alone, he is accompanied by his girlfriend, Safai. Anne appears awkward when talking to Safai, and it seems her feelings do not approve of the relationship Owen has. Anne's discomfort becomes more apparent when night falls, where she accidentally witnesses Owen and Safai playing games together. The next day, they go to celebrate Charlotte's birthday, the sister of Anne's ex-husband. Despite her age, Charlotte remains energetic and skillful in conversation. However, the atmosphere changes when the discussion shifts to a topic sensitive for Anne, the loss of her husband in an accident. Anne looks uncomfortable, especially when Charlotte mentions Anne's new fiancé, a man named David. Charlotte explains that the marriage was arranged by her, hoping that Emma wouldn't grow up without a father figure. This statement only adds to Anne's discomfort, until she unconsciously wipes Emma's dirty mouth roughly, causing her daughter to scream in fear. Safai tries to calm Anne, but instead receives a reprimand from Owen. Although the birthday celebration did not go smoothly, Charlotte reminds Anne not to behave like that again. She understands that and is still struggling to forget her late husband, but life must go on, and Anne must try to move on from her past. After the incident, Safai leaves Anne's house without leaving any message. Owen doesn't know where his girlfriend has gone, making the atmosphere in the house even more uncomfortable. One day, Anne sees Safai delivering a package to a customer. Curiosity drives Anne to follow her, until she arrives at a store that provides furniture repairs. With cunning, Anne pretends to want to repair a piece of furniture in her house and talks to the store owner. Shortly after, Safai is called to meet the customer, who turns out to be Anne herself. Safai looks surprised when she sees Anne, but Anne calmly explains that she didn't know Safai worked there. Safai then invites Anne for a drink together, so that the atmosphere between them doesn't feel awkward. In the conversation that followed, Anne finally asked Safai why she left without saying a word earlier. Safai replied that she just wanted to distance herself because she felt that Owen had changed since they started staying at Anne's house, and then opened up about her past, sharing how she was often left alone by her husband, who was busy with work. That loneliness eventually led her to adopt Owen when he was only 9 years old. Owen's presence became a comfort amidst her solitude until a tragic event took her husband, and from then on, everything changed. A few days after that meeting, Owen came home and found Safai already there. However, the atmosphere between them was cold, and no conversation took place. Feeling ignored, Safai finally decided to leave. It's unclear what was on Owen's mind, he seemed no longer in love with Safai, but he also wasn't ready to lose her. On one occasion, Owen contacted Anne, asking to meet so they could clear things up. However, Anne refused, saying that she would be busy until her wedding day. It seemed that Owen had deeper feelings for his stepmother. A few days later, when Anne came home, she found her fiancé, David, already waiting there. David had come because he was worried, as Anne had been difficult to reach lately. David mentioned that he couldn't stay long because of his piled-up work. Anne was equally busy, she said that she would be going to a bridal shop that night. To ease their longing, they played a game together, but Anne appeared expressionless, as if the emotional strain she felt outweighed her enthusiasm. That night, when Anne returned home, she found Owen already in the garage. Anne felt irritated seeing Owen and asked him to leave her house. However, Owen persisted and, full of emotion, declared his love for Anne. He pleaded with her not to marry David and tried to convince her to rekindle their relationship. Despite this, Anne was determined to forget Owen and distance herself from him. In the conversation that took place, it was revealed that when Owen was younger, while Anne's husband often left her for work, and had an illicit relationship with Owen. Emma, Anne's daughter, was actually the result of that relationship. Owen wanted to conduct a DNA test as soon as possible to confirm this because he didn't want Emma to be recognized as David's child when Anne married him later. However, Anne was overcome with fear and couldn't bring herself to do it. She thought about Charlotte, her ex-husband's sister, who might complicate things if she found out. Owen, who didn't care about Anne's concerns, gave her 2 days to handle the paperwork and get Emma's DNA results. A few days after the incident, Anne was truly overwhelmed by depression. One morning, just after waking up, Charlotte confronted Anne with a face full of anger. Charlotte questioned Anne's decision to cancel her wedding with David. It was then revealed that Anne was so obedient to Charlotte because the house and job she had were gifts from her ex-husband's family. Charlotte, as the last heir of her family, held full control over Anne's life. Anne, a strong woman who had been through various life trials, was now faced with a huge dilemma. Anne realized that David, her fiancé, was not the right person for her daughter, Emma. David had similarities with her late husband, who was often absent from home due to work, leaving his wife and child in loneliness. However, this time, Anne couldn't contradict the words that came out of Charlotte's mouth. It turned out that Charlotte had long known about the illicit relationship between Anne and her stepson, Owen. In fact, Charlotte knew everything that had happened between them. In the deepening pressure, Anne was forced to follow Charlotte's wishes. Charlotte asked her to meet at a restaurant in the afternoon, where they would discuss Anne's wedding plans with David. With a mind full of turmoil, Anne decided to visit her mother, hoping to find a bit of peace. However, this visit only added to the burden on Anne's heart. It turned out that all this time, Anne had never visited her mother since she decided to marry her previous husband, even without her mother's blessing. Even when Emma was born, Anne didn't inform her, leaving her mother deeply disappointed and feeling neglected. Disappointed with Anne's behavior, her mother asked her to leave the house immediately. Upon returning home, Anne was surprised by Owen's arrival, who invited her to forget all their problems for a while by playing. Anne, who was overwhelmed with confusion and pressure, ended up venting her emotions during the game with Owen. However, this action was noticed by David, who had come to pick up Anne. Without saying a word, David left them with feelings of disappointment and anger. Anne then quickly followed David to the restaurant where the meeting arranged by Charlotte was supposed to take place. But as soon as Anne arrived, a hard slap from Charlotte greeted her. Charlotte, furious with Anne's behavior, ordered her to leave and never wanted to see her again. After losing the chance to get married, losing her dignity, and now feeling lost, Anne finally made a big decision. She handed Emma over to Owen and decided to leave the city, ending all the relationships she had built over the years.